सेवेंथ चैप्टर का सेकेंड पार्ट, जैसे कि आपने जब चैप्टर स्टार्ट किया था, आई टोल्ड यू दैट द चैप्टर दैट इज डिवाइडेड इनटू टू, वन व्हिच इज नोन एज ए, व्हिच वाज द केमिकल इक्विलिब्रियम व्हिच वी डिस्कस्ड, एंड द सेकेंड वन दैट इज गोइंग टू बी आयनिक इक्विलिब्रियम. नाउ आयनिक इक्विलिब्रियम जो है दैट इज गोइंग टू बी द इक्विलिब्रियम ऑन बेस्ड ऑन द डिसोसिएशन ऑफ एनी इलेक्ट्रोलाइट इनटू इट्स रिस्पेक्टिव आयंस. ओके, सो उसके लिए हम लोग दो थ्योरी जो है, एक आपने आर्हेनियस थ्योरी ऑफ डिसोसिएशन करी थी जब हमने इलेक्ट्रोकेमिस्ट्री करा था, एंड द सेकेंड थ्योरी व्हिच वी आर गोइंग टू डू ओवर हियर दैट इज द ऑस्वाल्ड्स डाइल्यूशन लॉ. ओके, नाउ फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल लेट्स जस्ट अंडरस्टैंड कि हम लोग एक टर्म यूज कर रहे हैं. व्हाट डू वी अंडरस्टैंड बाय द टर्म इलेक्ट्रोलाइट? इलेक्ट्रोलाइट क्या हुआ? इलेक्ट्रोलाइट दैट इज द कंपाउंड्स व्हिच गिव्स आयंस इन मोल्टन और एक्वस स्टेट्स. ठीक है, सो जो भी आयंस में डिसोसिएट होते हैं इन मोल्टन और एक्वस स्टेट्स, उनको हम क्या बुलाते हैं? दे आर नोन एज इलेक्ट्रोलाइट्स. इलेक्ट्रोलाइट्स दे आर ऑफ टू टाइप्स. The first one, which are known as strong electrolytes. क्या होते हैं strong electrolytes? Strong electrolytes वो electrolytes हैं which are going to completely dissociate into their respective ions. Right? So there is going to be a complete dissociation in case of strong electrolytes. So all these strong electrolytes, they are going to be good conductors of electricity. They are going to be good conductors of electricity. Strong electrolytes ki bahut sare examples hain. Jaise for example, we have sodium chloride. Then we have HCl, we have potassium hydroxide, we have NaOH. All these, they are going to be strong electrolytes. And it is said that the degree of dissociation, that is alpha, for such electrolytes, that is going to be 100% or it is equal to 1. So complete dissociation of these substances into their respective ions, that is going to take place. The second we have is weak electrolytes. So what are these weak electrolytes? Those electrolytes which do not completely dissociate into their respective ions, they are going to be weak electrolytes. Examples which we can take over here is acetic acid. So acetic acid, that is going to be a weak electrolyte. Then we have phosphoric acid. Then we have HCl. This is also a weak electrolyte. Now in this case, the degree of dissociation alpha, that is always going to be less than 1. So complete dissociation is not taking place. Therefore alpha is not 100%. It is always going to be less than 100%. Now when we're talking of weak electrolytes, let's take the example of CH3COOH. So CH3COOH, that is going to dissociate into its respective ions CH3COO negative plus H positive. ठीक है, अब जब ये इसमें dissociate होती है तो you can see that for weak electrolytes at equilibrium both unionized acetic acid and ionized acetate ion and H positive, that is going to be present. Okay, now this is the equilibrium which is established for weak electrolytes, that is known as ionic equilibrium. In case of strong electrolytes, because complete dissociation is going to take place, so the unionized ions, they are not going to be present at equilibrium because complete formation of products will take place. But over here, ionic equilibrium is generally you can say calculated or expressed only for weak electrolytes. So this is the equilibrium, which is ionic equilibrium. Now we have discussed over here one point, which is the degree of dissociation. ये जो degree of dissociation होती है, this is equal to alpha. And mathematically, alpha that is going to be equal to what? Number of ions dissociated. Number of ions into which an electrolyte dissociates. Which an electrolyte dissociates divided by total number of ions at equilibrium. ठीक है, divided by total number of ions at equilibrium. So this is what we are going to discuss in this chapter. So let's go on to the first law which we are going to discuss, on the basis of which the ionic equilibrium that is established, which is known as the Ostwald's dilution law. Okay, now what is Ostwald's dilution law? Ostwald's dilution law. Now we know that according to the Arrhenius theory of electrolytic dissociation, whenever any electrolyte that is going to dissociate, the molecules of the electrolyte, they are constantly splitting into ions. ठीक है, so we have any unionized molecule, for example, if we are taking into consideration AB, AB is unionized. This is going to, when we melt it, it will ionize into A positive and B negative. Now, according to the Arrhenius theory, what is happening? This is getting dissociated into this, and this is getting combined to give us this, because as you can see over here, that the reaction that is going to be reversible. ठीक है, so the unionized will form ionized, and ionized they are going to come together to give us unionized. A point comes when the you can say the forward reaction that becomes equal to the backward reaction, and that is the point when equilibrium is going to exist. So we are saying whenever such a reaction is taking place, there is going to be a dynamic equilibrium between the both. Okay, so we're taking this again, we have AB which is getting dissociated into A positive and B negative. Over here, when we're looking initially, when the reaction has not begun, let's say that the concentration of AB that is equal to C, and the concentrations of A positive and B negative, both they are going to be equal to zero. Okay, now at equilibrium, certain amount of this gets ionized, okay, so it is getting dissociated. So the concentration of this now becomes C1 minus alpha, because initially it was 1, alpha of it has been dissociated, the concentration was C initially, C into 1, so that becomes equal to 1. If alpha has been dissociated, to C into 1 minus alpha, and the dissociation of the concentration of A positive, that is going to be C alpha, and the concentration of B negative is also going to be C alpha. If you're looking at the equilibrium constant for this reaction K, that will be equal to concentration of A positive into concentration of B negative upon concentration of AB. ठीक है, so A positive की concentration कितनी हो जाती है, C alpha into C alpha upon C 1 minus alpha, or this can be written as K is equal to C alpha square upon 1 minus alpha. ठीक है, now when we're looking at a weak electrolyte, when we're looking at a weak electrolyte, it is seen that the value of alpha is very, very less as compared to 1, because it is not completely dissociating. Because alpha is very, very less than 1, therefore this term in the denominator that can be ignored. ठीक है, so हमारे पास क्या आ जाएगा, k value equal to c alpha square. In order to calculate the value of अच्छा c square alpha square आएगा यहाँ पे, और फिर उसके बाद ये c और ये c कट जाता है, आप यही पे काट दो इसको, ये c और ये c कट गया, so we have c alpha square upon 1 minus alpha. Okay, so over here if you need to find the value of alpha, that is degree of dissociation, that will be equal to what? K upon C ka under root, that is going to become equal to alpha. Okay, so this is the Ostwald's dilution law. Now, according to this, degree of dissociation, that is going to be the under root of the quotient of K upon C. Okay, that is what alpha is going to be. Then we come to another very important effect over here, which we will study many times in this chapter, which is the common ion effect. The common ion effect. Now, what do you understand by common ion effect over here? Let's say that we are taking a weak electrolyte AB. Again, this AB that is going to dissociate as A positive plus B negative, right? And if we're talking of the dissociation constant K, that will become equal to concentration of A positive, concentration of B negative upon concentration of AB. Okay. Now we are adding one electrolyte to this solution. That electrolyte may have, so what are we doing? We are adding an electrolyte. Which is having either A positive or B negative. दोनों में से कोई भी एक आयन उसके अंदर प्रेजेंट है. Okay. Now what will happen? अगर सपोज हम उस इलेक्ट्रोलाइट को इसके अंदर डालेंगे तो रिवर्स रिएक्शन इज गोइंग टू टेक प्लेस बिकॉज द कॉन्सेंट्रेशन ऑफ द प्रोडक्ट्स विल इंक्रीज. लेट्स से इफ A पॉजिटिव इज कॉमन. Okay. Even if A positive is common, the concentration of A positive that is going to increase and the reaction will go in the reverse direction. If the reaction is going in the reverse direction over here, on doing this, there is going to be no change in the value of K. Or we say that the value of K that becomes a constant. So this is known as what? It is known as the common ion effect. Let's take an example over here. Matlab, the suppression of change in value of equilibrium constant on adding an electrolyte which have at least one of the ions as common, that is going to be known as common ion effect. Now let's take the example of acetic acid. Acetic acid is a weak electrolyte. ये डिसोसिएट हो जाएगा इनटू CH3CO नेगेटिव और H पॉजिटिव. ठीक है, अब हम इसके अंदर एक स्ट्रॉन्ग इलेक्ट्रोलाइट डाल देते हैं व्हिच इज सोडियम एसीटेट. सोडियम एसीटेट इज अ स्ट्रॉन्ग इलेक्ट्रोलाइट. नाउ दिस इज गोइंग टू डिसोसिएट इनटू CH3CO नेगेटिव प्लस Na पॉजिटिव. ओके, जब हमने इसके अंदर ये वाला इलेक्ट्रोलाइट डाला तो हमारे पास ये कॉमन आयन हो गया. इस कॉमन आयन की वजह से रिएक्शन विल गो इन द रिवर्स डायरेक्शन. बिकॉज द रिएक्शन इज गोइंग इन द रिवर्स डायरेक्शन, देयरफॉर द वैल्यू ऑफ के डज नॉट चेंज, इट बिकम्स और इट इज द सेम. ठीक है, सो दैट इज व्हाट कॉमन आयन इफेक्ट इज. व्हेन वी टॉकिंग ऑफ कॉमन आयन इफेक्ट, वन ऑफ इट्स very important you can say application is to suppress the acidic strength of acids. To suppress the acidic strength of acids. Now because over here you can see that CH3COOH that is going to behave as an acid. Okay, now on adding this electrolyte over here, we are going to lose the forward reaction, जिसकी वजह से H positive यहाँ पे release हो रहा है. जब रिएक्शन बैकवर्ड डायरेक्शन में चली जाएगी तो H पॉजिटिव तो रिलीज ही नहीं होगा, तो उससे हम क्या कर रहे हैं, CH3COOH को और वीक एसिड बना रहे हैं बाय एडिंग एनी सच इलेक्ट्रोलाइट जिसके पास कॉमन आयन है. ओके, सो दिस इज व्हाट कॉमन आयन इफेक्ट इज. वी विल स्टडी दिस लेटर अगेन व्हेन वी वांट टू डू द बफर सॉल्यूशंस. सो दैट इज, दिस इज द बेस ऑफ द बफर सॉल्यूशंस जो हम बाद में पढ़ेंगे. Another important concept जिसमें से आपको question आता है, that is the solubility product. Solubility product. Let's understand this now. When we talking of solubility, it is seen that whenever a given amount of a solute that is going to be added into a solvent in a given amount, in a specified amount of a solvent at a given temperature, that is going to be known as solubility. मतलब कि कितना सोल्यूट, मेजर्ड अमाउंट ऑफ सोल्यूट हम एक मेजर्ड अमाउंट ऑफ सॉल्वेंट के अंदर डालते हैं एट रूम टेम्परेचर, वो उसकी एक पर्टिकुलर सॉल्ट की सॉल्युबिलिटी होती है. ओके, सो व्हाट वी आर डूइंग ओवर हियर इज कि सपोज हम सॉल्यूट ऐड करते चले जा रहे हैं. अगर हम सॉल्यूट ऐड करते चले जाएंगे, एक टाइम ऐसा आएगा जब सॉल्यूट उसमें डिसॉल्व ही नहीं होगा. बिकॉज अगर आप एक ग्लास ले रहे हो पानी का, उसमें आप एक चम्मच चीनी का डालोगे, इट इज गोइंग टू डिसॉल्व, दो डालोगे डिसॉल्व, थ्री डालोगे डिसॉल्व. बट इफ यू गोइंग टू पुट 1 kg ऑफ शुगर इन 1 glass ऑफ वाटर, इट इज नॉट इवन गोइंग टू फिट. ओके, सो लेट्स से दैट यू आर पुटिंग से 250 ग्राम्स ऑफ शुगर यू आर ट्राइंग टू डिसॉल्व इन 1 glass ऑफ वाटर, इट विल नॉट डिसॉल्व. ओके, सो अ पॉइंट कम्स व्हेन नो मोर ऑफ द सॉल्यूट डिसॉल्व्स of the solute dissolves in a specified amount of solvent. ठीक है, initially when we were putting in and putting in the solute or solute dissolve होता जा रहा था, उसको हम लोग क्या बुलाते हैं, that is known as an unsaturated solution. Now, जब सॉल्यूट ने मना कर दिया या सॉल्वेंट ने मना कर दिया कि अब मैं और डिसॉल्व नहीं करूंगा, तो उस सॉल्यूशन को अब हम क्या बुला रहे हैं, that is known as a saturated solution. Now, when we talking of saturated solution, it is seen that whenever we have, say again we are having one salt in the form of AB, this is a solid. इसको हमने वाटर के अंदर डाला, सो वी गेट नाउ AB विच इज अनआयोनाइज्ड, विच इज इन द फॉर्म ऑफ डिसॉल्व सॉल्ट. नाउ एज वी पुट दिस इन वाटर, इट इज गोइंग टू डिसोसिएट इनटू इट्स रिस्पेक्टिव आयंस सच दैट वी हैव A पॉजिटिव एंड B नेगेटिव. सो दीज आर द आयंस विच आर गोइंग टू बी फॉर्म्ड. ओके, now since solution that is saturated, what is going to happen to the concentration? The concentration over here for saturated solution, that is going to become constant. So the concentration becomes constant. Okay, अब concentration हमारी constant हो गई. अगर concentration constant हो जाती है तो इसका मतलब क्या हुआ, the concentration of AB at this particular point, ये constant हो जाएगी. अगर हम इस वाली reaction का equilibrium constant लिखें, तो K that is equal to what? Concentration of A positive, B negative, upon concentration upon of AB. Now we say कि let's take AB on the other side. That is equal to concentration of A positive into concentration of B negative. अब ये हम बोल रहे हैं for saturated solution, the concentration of AB in the dissolved solution, that is going to be a constant. So concentration of AB यहाँ पे क्या हो गई? It is going to be a constant. So K into this constant, or you can write this as K into a constant, that is equal to concentration of A positive into concentration of B negative. ठीक है, this into this constant, this is known as the solubility product. which is denoted by KSP. So therefore, KSP, that is going to define, or that is going to depend only on the ions which are going to be present in a solution. Okay, now if we are taking a weak electrolyte, let's calculate the solubility product. Let's calculate the solubility product of a weak electrolyte. So over here we are taking one salt AmBn. ठीक है? अब ये जब dissociate होगा, तो ये कैसे dissociate होगा? Ma raised to power n positive plus Nb raised to power n negative. Cross multiply the valencies. ठीक है? So let's say that the solubility of this initially, that is given by S, and the solubility of this and this, that both will be equal to zero. Okay, now at equilibrium, we are saying that certain amount that is going to be dissociated. So, जितना अमाउंट डिसोसिएट हो रहा है उसको हम ले लेते हैं अल्फा इनटू द कॉन्सेंट्रेशन एस अल्फा. ठीक है, और जो ए पॉजिटिव आयंस है वो कितने हो जाएंगे? एम इनटू एस अल्फा. ठीक है, सो वी हैव एम इनटू एस अल्फा एंड ये क्या हो गया? एम इनटू एस अल्फा. ओके, नाउ लेट्स गो ऑन टू द वैल्यू ऑफ के एस पी. नाउ so we calculating KSP over here, what is the value of KSP? KSP is equal to concentration of A, N positive raised to power M, and into B, kya aega? M negative raised to power N. ठीक है, ये आ गया. Let's put the concentrations. Concentration इसकी क्या है? Ms alpha raised to power m, okay, and Ns alpha raised to power n. ठीक है, यही आ गया. So इसको हम किस तरह से लिख सकते हैं? Ksp that is going to be equal to m raised to power m, right, into n raised to power n. ठीक है, इनटू एस अल्फा कॉमन ले लिया हमने यहां पे, एंड पावर्स को हम ऐड कर देते हैं एम प्लस एन. सो दिस इज हाउ यू कैलकुलेट द सॉल्युबिलिटी ऑफ अ वीक इलेक्ट्रोलाइट. देन वी हैव सीन दैट समटाइम्स व्हेन वी आर मिक्सिंग एनी सॉल्यूट इन अ सॉल्वेंट देयर इज सडनली अ प्रेसिपिटेशन व्हिच इज गोइंग टू टेक प्लेस. ओके, नाउ व्हेन डज दैट प्रेसिपिटेशन टेक प्लेस, और व्हाट इज द criteria for precipitation? A very simple criteria of precipitation is that whenever the value of, this is an important question from your competition point of view, ye aata hai aapko, whenever the ionic product is greater than, whenever the ionic product is greater than solubility product, precipitation is going to occur. ठीक है, जब भी ionic product, अब ionic product क्या हुआ? अगर suppose हम लोग एक इस तरह से B negative ये ले रहे हैं, so the value of K over here, that is equal to concentration of A positive into concentration of B negative upon concentration of AB. This is going to be the ionic product. Now in ionic product, we are not taking the concentration of AB as constant like we are taking in KSP. So whenever the value of ionic product is greater than what? The KSP,
then precipitation that is going to occur. So let's discuss a few cases over here. First case jo hum yahan pe dekh rahe hai, that is case 1, when the value of ionic product that is less than Ksv, right, then the solution that is unsaturated. Which means that more solute can dissolve in the solvent. Okay, so agar ye unsaturated hai, then no precipitation is going to occur. Clear ho gaya? Second case hamare paas kya hai? When the value of ionic product that is equal to the value of solubility product. Theek hai? Dono ki values they are same. तब सॉल्यूशन जो है दैट इज गोइंग टू बी सैचुरेटेड, राइट? और अगर सॉल्यूशन सैचुरेटेड है तो इसका मतलब नो मोर सॉल्यूट कैन बी डिसॉल्व्ड. देन द थर्ड केस व्हिच वी हैव दैट इज व्हेन द वैल्यू ऑफ केआईपी इज ग्रेटर देन केएसपी. ओके, नाउ इन दिस केस the solution that is going to be super saturated. So the molecules of the solute, they can easily form bonds with each other and hence precipitation in this case that is going to take place. Samajh aa gaya? So PPT is taking place. So isme aapko question kaisa aata hai? They have given you the values of A positive, B negative. And they will also, concentrations will be given to you. So concentrations agar de rakhi hai, you have to calculate the ionic product, then you will calculate the solubility product. Agar aapko lagega ki ionic product ki value zyada aa rahi hai solubility product se, to precipitation will occur, otherwise it will not occur. So these are simple kind of questions which come from this kya kehte hain usko section. Okay, then another very important you can say application of the solubility product is it tells us or it helps us to calculate solubility. So KSP that is going to help us to calculate solubility. This is the first application which we have done. This is going to be the second application. Okay, now how do you calculate solubility? Solubility that can be calculated for different types of salts by different formulas. So this is another important topic from your competition point of view over here. We say that if we have, the first we are going to discuss salts of AB type. Okay, salts of AB type, hamare paas kaun kaun se aa gaye? We have NaCl, we have AgCl, AgI, all these they are going to be salts of AB type. Okay, so let's see it is just a dissociate kar raha hai. We have AB over here, which is going to be dissociated as A positive and B negative. Okay, so what is going to be, let's say that the solubility due to this is S and solubility due to this is also S. Now according to the solubility product, KSP that is going to be equal to concentration of A positive into concentration of B negative. Concentration A ki kya li hai humne S aur dusre ki bhi kya li hai S, theek hai? So hamare paas KSP kya aa jayega, S square. Aur you can calculate the solubility from here, that is KSP ka under root that is going to be equal to S. Okay, so this is how if they have given you any salt of this type and they tell you to calculate the solubility, so solubility kya jayegi? Under root of KSP. Then next, let's go on to the second type of salts over here. Second type of salts hum le rahe hain AB2 or A2B, either of the two. Okay, examples jo ki hum log yahan pe le sakte hain, that is silver carbonate, Ag2CO3, or you can take PbCl2. These are the examples. So let's see how these are going to dissociate now. We have AB2 which is dissociating into A positive plus 2B negative. Okay, now the solubility of this is S. The solubility of this, that is going to be 2S. Clear ho gaya? So KSP kya aa jayega? Concentration of A positive into concentration of B negative ka square. Because of the stoichiometry, so yahan pe hamare paas aa gaya solubility due to this is S. The solubility due to this is 2S. So we want to take the square of 2S. Theek hai? So this is going to become equal to S into 4S square, or which becomes into equal to 4S cube. Now KSP divided by 4 ka cube root, that is going to be equal to S. Okay? So this is what the second application is, how to calculate the solubility. Then we have another important calculations which can be done on the basis of KSP. Let's see what kya hai. Alright. So we have over here calculation of remaining concentration after precipitation. Now precipitation has taken place. उसके बाद सॉल्यूशन के अंदर क्या कॉन्सेंट्रेशन रह जाती है सॉल्यूट की, दैट वी कैन कैलकुलेट बाय दिस फॉर्मूला. नाउ लेट्स से ओवर हियर दैट वी हैव टेकिंग सेइंग दैट वी हैव अगेन द सेम काइंड ऑफ सॉल्ट ए बी टू गिव अस ए पॉजिटिव एंड बी नेगेटिव, राइट. अब क्या होता है कि समटाइम्स देयर आर सर्टेन अमाउंट ऑफ आयंस व्हिच आर गोइंग टू बी लेफ्ट even after the precipitation is done. So remaining concentration that can be determined by the following methods. Let's say that we have to calculate the remaining concentration of A positive in the solution. That can be calculated as KSP into concentration of AB upon concentration of B negative. So this is the formula. क्लियर हो गया? अगर सपोज हम लोग ले रहे हैं वन इलेक्ट्रोलाइट व्हिच इज कैल्शियम हाइड्रोक्साइड एंड वी हैव टू कैलकुलेट कि Ca2 पॉजिटिव कितना इसमें बच गया व्हिच इज गोइंग टू बी लेफ्ट. सो दैट कैन बी गिवन एज द वैल्यू ऑफ केएसपी फॉर द सॉल्ट इनटू द कॉन्सेंट्रेशन ऑफ कैल्शियम हाइड्रोक्साइड upon the concentration of OH negative ka square. Why square we have taken over here? Because there are two moles of hydroxyl ions present in one calcium hydroxide solution. Okay, so percentage of precipitation kaise calculate karenge phir hum? Percentage of precipitation that can be calculated as initial concentration minus concentration left, or the left concentration as we have calculated over here, right? Initial concentration which was given upon left concentration, minus left concentration upon initial concentration. In 200. Okay, so this is how we are going to calculate, right? फिर इसमें एक और term आती है, which is known as simultaneous solubility. What is simultaneous solubility? It is the solubility of two electrolytes Having a common eye. Okay. Solubility of two electrolytes which are going to have a common ion, that is known as simultaneous solubility. For example, if we are taking over here two salts AgBr and AgCl. So the solubility over here, that is going to be known as simultaneous solubility. Or we have taken calcium fluoride and strontium fluoride. Okay? Or we have taken magnesium fluoride and calcium fluoride. So in this case, Ag is the common ion. In this case, fluorine is the common ion. And in this case, again, fluorine is the common ion. So in dono ki jo solubility hum log discuss karenge, that is going to be simultaneous solubility. So ye hamara ek part tayar hua hai questions ka. In our next class, we are going to do questions with respect to KSP. Okay? And then we go on to the next topic, which is acids, bases, ki sari theories, and the rest of the chapter. Okay?